Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video of StudyIQ, I will bring to you the current affairs of 24th of May. So let's start the video. StudyIQ's pen drive courses are available for different exams like SSC, UPSC, Bank PO and various other exam. We are running a sale till the end of this month. Do check out our website for more interesting offers, studyiq.com. You can follow me on social media. My Instagram ID is starlesssoul and Facebook ID is facebook.com/gauravgargeeducation. Pacific Vanguard. It is a naval exercise. It is being held between how many countries? There are four countries that are participating in it: America, Japan, Australia, and South Korea. Okay, so all the four countries are very important from a strong Indo-Pacific point of view, because America, Japan, and Australia are part of Quad along with India. So the answer is four. Australia conducted a military exercise with other countries called Pitch Black last year, in which Indian Air Force participated for the first time. And India and Japan exercise is called Dharma Guardian. It was conducted in Mizoram. And India and America, they do lot of exercises together. Like for example, COP India, for example, Vajra Prahar, for example, Yudh Abhyas. And then India along with America and Japan do Malabar exercise, both of all the three, they do Malabar exercise. Which country's seventh king, Sultan Ahmed Shah, has passed away recently? He was 88 years old. And he passed away. He was the king of Malaysia. Okay. Now, can you tell me who is the new king of Thailand? Who is the new king of Thailand? Thailand's capital is Bangkok. And Bangkok will host the ASEAN summit this year in 2019. The 34th ASEAN summit will take place in Thailand. What was the rank of India in the Kids Right Index? Kids Right Index basically shows the, you know, the children's rights in a country. India secured 117th position out of 181 countries. Best country in this was Iceland. Number one was Iceland. Which of the following paramilitary forces it has signed the charter of affiliation with the Indian Coast Guard to enhance the inter-forces cooperation and interoperability? Basically a synergy. They are exploring synergy, Indian Coast Guard with recently Assam Rifles. Now Assam Rifles takes care of our border with Myanmar, and the Indian Coast Guard recently, they decommissioned their ship called Vigraha. Vigraha was name of the Indian Coast Guard ship that was decommissioned. And Indian Coast Guard does exercise with the Vietnam Coast Guard, that is called Sahyog Hop Tak. Sahyog Hop Tak. Clear? Understood or not understood? And then the India and the Japan Coast Guard, they do a military exercise called Sahyog Kaijin. Sahyog Kaijin. World Turtle Day was observed on which day? World Turtle Day is 23rd of May. 23rd of May. And the theme this time was very significant. It was Adopt, Don't Shop. Because, you know, that the shell of the turtle is used for making different handbags and products. So Adopt Turtle, Don't Shop Turtles. Which of the following life insurance company it has been conferred with the FICCI Claims Excellence Award? Which company am I talking about? It is Bharti AXA. Bharti AXA. Who will be honored with the United Nations highest peacekeeping award called Captain Mabai Diagn Medal for exceptional courage after his death? He will be given this award posthumously. His name is Chensi Chitet. Chensi Chitet. And he was honored with the award. Also remember, India is the fourth largest contributor to the United Nations peacekeeping forces. Ethiopia right now is number one. According to the Quick Hill Security Labs report, which city is the most vulnerable to cyber attacks in 2019? The most vulnerable is Mumbai. In India, it is Mumbai. Who was recently presented with an honorary degree by the prestigious Yale University? She is Indra Nui, the former CEO of PepsiCo. Right now, the CEO of PepsiCo is Ramon Laguarta. Ramon Laguarta. The Indian Air Force has successfully test-fired the aerial version of the supersonic BrahMos cruise missile from which fighter aircraft? BrahMos, if you split the two, Bra stands for Brahmaputra and Mos stands for Moskva, which is a river in Moscow. So BrahMos missile we have made with the help of Russia. And they recently test fired it from Su-30 MKI. And again, these are Russian aircrafts. Which bank has tied up with the FMCG, fast moving consumer goods arm of the Art of Living, which is called Shri Shri Tattva? So the Art of Living Foundation, they have launched their own FMCG products called Shri Shri Tattva, and the bank that has partnered with them is the State Bank of India. The 5th Smart Cities India 2019 Expo was inaugurated in which city? There are 100 smart cities which are to be built in India, and the meet was in New Delhi. Smart Cities is an initiative of the Ministry of Housing and Urban Development. The World Health Organization, it has declared which two countries as malaria-free. The two countries that are malaria-free now is Algeria and Argentina. Algeria and Argentina. India also started something known as Mera India. It was a program basically to eliminate malaria. Okay, Malaria Elimination Research Alliance, that is called MERA. So Algeria and Argentina. Who has become the first Pakistani mountaineer to scale 7 peaks in 7 continents? That is the respective 7 highest peaks. He has become the first Pakistani person to do so. His name is Mirza Ali. Mirza Ali. And if I talk about the Indian person, recently Satyarup Siddhant, he climbed all the 7 peaks and he became the youngest in the world to do so. Who has become the first HIV infected person to climb Mount Everest, the highest peak of the world? What is his name? He is Gopal Shrestha. He's suffering from AIDS. He's HIV positive and he's the first HIV infected person to climb Mount Everest. Who is the author of the book Coming Round the Mountain? Coming Round the Mountain was recently launched by Ruskin Bond. Very famous and everybody, you know, like every child's favorite author, Ruskin Bond. Who has won the Indian Women's League Championship Trophy? Indian Women's Champions League Trophy was won by Setu Football Club. Setu Football Club, they defeated Manipur Police in the final by a score of 3-1. The final took place in the Guru Nanak Stadium in Ludhiana, in Punjab. Which bank has given in-principle approval for financing 4 metro rail projects and 30,000 crore rapid rail corridor between Delhi and Meerut? 30,000 crore rapid rail corridor between Delhi and Meerut will be financed by the Asian Development Bank, headquartered in Manila. India is the 4th largest shareholder in this bank. The 2nd Urban Mayor Summit was held in which country? It took place in Japan. Remember, in Japan, in Osaka, the G20 meeting is starting next month. Name the judge who was recently appointed to the Supreme Court. Aniruddh Bose, A.S. Bopanna, B.R. Gawai, Surya Kant, the answer is all of the above. So these are the 4 new judges in the Supreme Court of India. Very important. Which country has successfully test-fired surface-to-surface ballistic missile called Shaheen 2? Shaheen 2 is a missile of Pakistan. The UNESCO World Heritage Site called Complex du Capitole, it is based in which city? The Capitol Complex, it is in Chandigarh. Recently, Kiran Kher won the Lok Sabha election from Chandigarh. So Chandigarh is the Lok Sabha constituency of Kiran Kher, wife of Anupam Kher. The Food Safety and Standards Authority of India was established in which year? It was established in 2011. So the answer is C. Which of these is not a folk dance of Gujarat? Nati, Bhavai, Padhar and Tippani. The answer is Nati. Nati is a dance which is in Sirmaur district and Kullu district and Shimla district of Himachal Pradesh, Nati. Okay, that's it for yesterday, that is 24th of May, and just wait half an hour maybe and you will get the videos of 25th May also. So our pen drive course sale is going on. If you want to avail heavy discounts, then please visit studyiq.com and don't forget to follow me on social media, Facebook or Instagram.